never come, but the memories live on. Be strong, don't cry when I'm gone. This life is a path to infinity.
Tonight, from Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, California, it's week two of the NFL preseason on EA Sports. The San Francisco 49ers taking on the Houston Texans.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Tonight, it's a preseason matchup between the Houston Texans and the San Francisco 49ers. Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis, happy to be back alongside you. And I'll tell you what, yes, it's just week two of the preseason, but now they've got one game under their belts and a lot of guys trying to prove some stuff down on the field here today.
Not only that, these coaches like to win. And I used to think it really didn't matter who won in the preseason. Then I watched some of those shows that the NFL does, and you see the coaches in preseason after a loss jumping all over their guys. So I learned one valuable lesson. Wins and losses count no matter what time of year it is.
So out come the Texans for their opening drive. And they will be led out by their rookie quarterback.
I tell you what, when he is on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one is capable of challenging any level of the defense on any given play. That's why so many scouts preach arm talent when preparing for the NFL draft. A quarterback with arm strength to make every throw in the book, he's an asset to have in any offense.
They'll start on the ground with Pierce. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they're in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. To throw again. Good. Escaping the pressure right. He'll get this into the hands of Nico Collins. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
And that's a nice throw right there. And I'll tell you what I've seen in recent times and actually watched a presentation in the offseason from a college offensive coordinator that showed about 10 different drills that he runs with his quarterbacks to show them how to get out of the pocket, how to get comfortable when they're doing so, and to make plays under that type of duress. That's an example of what we're seeing the colleges deliver to the NFL.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
They've created a nice sustained drive off of plays like that. A nice strong run there that keeps them advancing the ball.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Good. That's underneath to Pierce. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. And gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. And really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Taken down at the 30.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
To throw on 2nd down. Good. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. Play number 9 set to come here on the drive on 3rd and 2. Pierce will try to pick it up. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. Give him the 3rd down conversion, 5 yards on the play. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
Throwing on 1st down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. You know, during these preseason games, we're in week 2 right now, it's always funny looking at our spot charts up here in the booth, because with all the guys that might play in this one, it seems to get bigger and bigger each year.
Yeah, we pretty much supersize them, don't we? Because, you know, remember, they're carrying 90 now. And with the new rules, they'll carry 90 all the way through the preseason before they make the final cut. Oh, yeah, a lot of guys to learn for these games.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on 3rd down.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Back to throw. Good. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. The big man, get the oxygen tank ready. He's at the 40. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line. Always fun to watch a big boy pick it up and go. He may need a little oxygen on it. He may need a lot of oxygen on the sideline.
Not only that, how about you and me trying to balance ourselves up here, because you can feel the shaking all the way up to the booth. That big guy trying to get it to the house.
So here are the 49ers and their offense in great field position already. They'll be led out by the former number 3 overall pick back in 2021. It's Trey Lance. Following the fumble recovery, Lance. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jonathan Greenard running in to pick up the sack. And they get to him right out of the gate. And this defense hoping that that's a harbinger of things to come.
Yeah, when you give up a first play sack, makes your quarterback wonder if he's going to go to the sidelines and talk with his offense coordinator and head coach and say, hey, you know that game plan we put together? We might need to change it right now.
Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And that'll make it 3rd and 13. Not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. call it a loss of four there on the sack. And speaking of the number four, it brings up fourth down now.
They'll make that a second sack here on their first drive out defensively. And not to get ahead of ourselves, but they're on pace for double-digit sacks at this point.
But they're going to have to find a way to tamp that down, aren't they? So if you're the play caller, you're telling your quarterback maybe some screens, maybe some draws, hard count, use your voice inflection a little bit, anything to try and slow that pressure down.
Now Cody Parkey out to try the field goal. It'll be a 49-yard attempt from the left hash. The kick by Parkey is good, and the 49ers take a 3-0 lead.
So the defense are able to force their first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game. They fumbled the last time they had the football. Fortunate that it only led to a field goal. 3-0 the score as they start first and 10. 19, 19. Off play action. Good. Rolling to it, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Looking to throw. Good. He's going to look deep down the field. And this is going to be intercepted. Nick Needham picks it off. Shotgun and hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about since training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. From the shotgun now, here's an in. Now a loose football, the ball comes out. Or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
Lance finding Kittle, first down San Francisco. Costly mistake, but as it turns out, they keep possession.
You can't give away these types of opportunities in the red zone. And I'm sure that was flashing through his brain as the ball escaped his hands. Fortunately for him, able to get picked up by his team, fumble recovered, they still have an opportunity deep in the red zone.
And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Two running plays, each lose a yard. They'll need to do much better now on third and 12. Now Lance. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. That
that time, multiple defenders getting pressure, and it's a loss of six.
It goes up to how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal? That's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. Now Cody Parkey out to try the field goal. From the left hash, this from 37. The kick by Parkey is good. And that will make it 6-0. So they get the turnover in plus territory. The drive stalls out, but still able to get three out of that.
Yeah, we were able to see an offense and a defense kind of mix and match with each other, didn't we? Both of them trying to make sure that they have the upper hand and the advantage. Offense trying to get to the end zone. Defense, of course, trying to hold them to a field goal attempt. And it wasn't a guaranteed lock three from where they started. So, you know, the offense has to be happy to come away with those 3 points.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. 6-0, our score after one. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Back to throw. Good. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And into the end zone, a pick six for the 49er D as they score the touchdown. An excellent play there, CD, on the pick six. And I think were they a nickel? Did they have an extra DB out there?
Yeah, Brandon, I think they were in standard nickel, not the Buffalo, as teams like to call it, meaning three safeties for big nickel. They just wanted to take away the quarterback's throwing lanes, and that's exactly what they did and came through with a big-time pick six.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. And now out comes Houston. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we're having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally, we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here.
Timing is so important on a route like this because he's going to line up out right, then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
Looking to throw on second down. Good. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. See what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. Under pressure, and they got to him again. That's Azeez Al-Shaair getting through for the sack that time. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it off, and they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And he is going to lose yardage here. This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of teams are running it. These wide receivers, a lot of them, they run like running backs with the ball in their hands.
And incomplete. As we thought they might do here in week two of the preseason, they've left their starting quarterback out there for the second quarter. But I would imagine we will not see him after halftime.
Yeah, this is the time of year you've got to get your backup some reps and make sure you protect your starting quarterback.
And he stopped up short of the first as they tackle him down at about the 36. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down. Now Cody Parkey out to try the field goal. From the right hash, this from 53. He's got the leg, but it's no good. He missed it right, and the lead will hold at 13. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
So now here in the second week of the preseason, you'd expect the starters to play a little bit more than they did in week one, but not a whole lot.
So if you're an offensive coordinator, what are you looking for?
What you're looking for is things getting cleaned up as you go along, because most of your playbook's probably installed. How well are they handling it? Easy in and out of the huddle? No mental mistakes? Are they starting to look like a good offensive football team?
He's got his man. It's the tight end, Brevin Jordan. On fourth down. Good. Open man there is Collins, complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive. Back to throw again. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's second down.
With a rookie quarterback out there, you're definitely going to find out how he handles adversity, because this one so far hasn't gone according to plan. He's got to fight through it and show him what he's made of.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved, because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well, because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Touchdown! A 15-yard touchdown grab, and the Texans have cut it back within a score. Charles, that's a pretty good response from a rookie quarterback. He's had his struggles in this game, including the interception on the last drive, but there he takes him down the field and puts it in the end zone.
I agree with everything you just said right there, and there's a silver lining to all this, his resiliency, because let's face it, when things are going bad and you're a youngster, they often continue to go bad. But in his mind and his actions, he said, this stops right here. And how about the positive play he just turned in?
And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25.
And now this offense comes back out onto the field.
Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe.
He's got a man complete.
And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped.
That one good for 37 yards.
I think we already know that this guy's going to be ready when they ring the bell for week one. That play, almost routine for him, but still, nice to know that he's still got it.
A first down run, good for about three. Second and seven coming up.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
Man, this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Corners are known for their ability to cover, but those that'll stick their nose in against the running game, that's a bonus for any team. And what a nice play right there, tackling him for a loss.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Throwing now is Lance. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
He already came through for them on this drive. No surprise that they were hoping he could do it again.
They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down.
And Lance going to throw.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
That time, multiple defenders getting pressure, and it's a loss of six. So that now four first-half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
And, partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's a game plan that they've had so far because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
Now Cody Parkey out to try the field goal. This is a 40-yard attempt from the left hash. The kick by Parkey is good. And now it's a two-score game at 9-16-7. So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about one-score lead, two-score lead, etc. But this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
And able to get this out to the 25. Second quarter action, 1:56 remaining. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I'd warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out, but I don't think there's any worries with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
On second down, here's Pierce. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The 49ers have an extra defensive back on the field, a nickel set for third down.
Looking to throw. Good. Flush to his right. And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Try and throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out, and the Niners take over in terrific field position. First down, Lance. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. The 40. Past the 20. And they will score a pick six for the Texans TD. Well, in a tight game like this, that could be an incredibly important pick six, CD. And remember, it cancels out the one that the opposition had earlier in this ball game.
You're right about that, partner, because each side came up with plays to swing the momentum their way. Still plenty of time left for either team to come through with a win, though. Can someone else make a similar play and win it for their club?
Fairbairn good with the extra point, and the lead is down to two. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And not an abundance of time remains on the clock, Charles, but you would think more than enough to try to extend this lead before intermission.
And when you're talking about extending the lead, I think you're talking about aiming for the end zone, because there is plenty of time for that. The fallback is to get three. But in your mind, you put six on the board right before the half. That's a heck of a dagger and great momentum to carry into the locker room.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. On first and 10, here's Lance. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
Well, they certainly did a nice job there, picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with him. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
On second and 10, Lance. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Lance looks to throw again. Here's Mitchell with a catch out of the backfield. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. So on fourth down, out comes Bradley Pinion to punt this one away. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. They go play action here on first down. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Shot before break. Good. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. So we have reached halftime here in a tight two-point contest. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in just a minute. Week two of the preseason is upon us. Each team now with just one more game after this one, and then we will get it all started as we normally do on the first Thursday after Labor Day. In our game, still a lot to keep an eye on. Guys battling, trying to make a ball club. We'll send it back to two guys already on our team. That's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. Expect to see a good number of backups going forward as we are back and underway here in preseason week two. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. The 49er offense set to go to begin quarter number three. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14.
Not too shabby for his first carry of the game. That's exactly what most teams are looking for, a really good change of pace back.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Davis Price on first and 10. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Here's the option play now to the left. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. 14 yards that time, and a first down on the keeper. And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. He'll buy some time right. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20. Purdy to throw it on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Touchdown, 49ers. Ray McCloud, 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Niners take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Parkey with the extra point, and that makes this a nine-point game. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. So here's the Texans offense now. They get set to start this third quarter. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially. But you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
And movement here by one of the Texans up front. In comes the flag. The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
A false start penalty, and now they're back to needing 10 yards on second down. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down.
When he runs, he seems to do a nice job of knowing when to be patient and find the hole. And then when the hole is there, he goes quickly.
You're exactly right. He knows how to just take off. But you know what else? Brings a little thump with him, doesn't he?
He does.
He packs the boom at the end of the run and finishes it going forward. That's what you want to see out of your backs.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Willis now off of play action. Out to his left. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
On second down, they'll run it here. And they'll get him down here at about the 42. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he is going to have a Texans first down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on 3rd and 3.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. This will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Texans up front. In comes the flag.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
They were looking good on 2nd down, but now they're backed up 5 yards by the false start, and it's 2nd and 8. Following the penalty, they'll go back to the run game. And able to get this to the 24-yard line. They began the play at the 12. It's also a pickup of 12 for the first down.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's 2nd and goal. They're mounting a nice drive here. Good chunk of yardage there again. O-line, they've been solid this drive.
They have that look about them right now that says, if you do anything but run the ball behind us, you're crazy. They have really moved it well on this drive, and they want to finish it off the same way.
From the 2 now, 2nd and goal.
They'll try again.
And he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Texans have got it back to within a score.
So a strong drive here to lead off this third quarter and gets them right back in this football game.
And I think we can safely call that a statement drive, because they had to be saying, we have put our best foot forward in the first half, but we certainly mean business now. Maybe a better term, a prove-it drive. They proved it to themselves that they were ready to go.
On for the PAT, Kaimi Fairbairn. And the lead is down to 2. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run.
So the lead shaved to 2 now as the kickoff is away. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it.
The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do.
No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. And the Texans say they have it. They do.
You know, if this is the regular season, partner, we'd be talking about just how costly a mistake that was, but probably good for him to get it out of his system right now.
Just hope for him and the team it's not a sign of things to come.
Yeah, without a doubt. Plus, you got to worry about making the team. Those types of errors don't help you.
Following the fumble recovery, Willis. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Talanoa Hufanga. And the Niners are going to get the football here at their own 23. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky, because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack.
And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there. Second down.
End result of that one, a nice 4-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play action game, or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. On the move past the 40. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
They run the option here on first and 10. And a good-looking run there as he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18-yard line.
17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
It looked like almost a miscommunication defensively, because once he decided to keep it, he had pretty smooth sailing.
Yeah, it became a question of, wait a minute, who's got the quarterback? And when you talk about miscommunication, it's supposed to be called assignment football on the defensive side of the ball. But if the assignment gets mixed up, that's the end result.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more preseason football on EA Sports.
And they'll run on the inside handoff.
And here he'll get it down to the 7. A 5-yard gain there makes it first and goal. How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what was said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a 3-and-out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
Give him three on the gain there. Second and goal.
That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there, but that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
Hasty is not going to get a whole lot, maybe a yard down to the three. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw.
And it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. Juwan Jennings from 3 yards out. And the 49ers get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Parkey adds the extra point, and that makes this a 9-point game. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told, and it's polished off by a touchdown for San Francisco. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Houston set to take over. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. First down. That's to about the 28. Second down coming up. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. Play action. Here's Willis. For a right side here, complete. It's a big play, yet amazingly, because of how far they had to go, they're still looking at a second down here.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? Second down, they'll run it here. And this will be a Texans first down as he's got this up to the 40-yard line. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
Now Willis on first and 10. Throwing right, and that's complete. They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it, and that will bring up second down. Now a handoff running through the middle. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
It's not a huge breakaway run, but if your starting running back finishes the game with averages of 5 or 6 yards per touch, you'll take that every single time.
The offense on 3rd down tonight, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 4. Willis looking to throw it. Finds his man, it's John Metchie. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 41-yard line. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first. So from inside Niner territory now, this is 1st and 10 at the 41. Now Willis on 1st and 10. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. The Charles are trying to protect this lead late. Those are the types of mistakes they could afford to go without.
About the last thing you want to give them? is helping completing a comeback, which is exactly what that penalty does.
So the penalty yards marched off on the face mask. Here's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. To throw again on second down. Willis. Incomplete.
Coaches talk about it all the time. Players talk about it as well. Excellent job staying disciplined in coverage and making that stop. Inside the red zone, every stop like that could be preventing a possible touchdown.
A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Third down, it's Willis. Eluding the pressure right. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the five at the four. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. I love those plays. Fourth and one, that's who wants it more, this time the offense.
Yeah, there's a lot of hooting and hollering in there, right? A lot of contact and a lot of collisions as they try and find some space. Who's going to drop their hips, gain leverage, and move the other side backwards? We saw it there for the offense getting it done.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. And he'll run again. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. A great effort there. Ready for the regular season with his second touchdown of the game. And the Texans have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So the lead shaved to two now as the kickoff is away. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that tough conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you've got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
And a five-yard gain gets him to the 42. Well, at this stage, that's exactly what you want offensively. Good run on first down, stay in bounds, keep that clock rolling.
And look at that play chart that the play caller has in his hands right now. That's what you got to focus in on, because that's divided up by sections. And right now, he's looking at that four-minute offense section. What running plays do we have to bleed down the clock and take care of the football? Right now, they're executing really well.
Got the time. second down, and again, it's Davis Price.
And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
7 yards there and a first down. And remember, no overtime here in preseason. This offense hoping that's a moot issue as they try to finish this one off. Another touch for Davis Price.
And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Second down, here's Davis Price.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, 3rd and 5. And now the Texans want to call another timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. And the Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on 3rd down.
Purdy.
He's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 22-yard line. The Texans going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. Down to a knee for the 49ers. This one about to be on ice. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up 2nd down. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it. San Francisco, and I tell you what, they were big favorites coming in, but they had to work for this one.
It certainly wasn't the walk in the park that you expected coming into this one. I have a suspicion that in their meetings next week, head coach going to talk to them a little bit about focus, don't you think?
Yeah, because down the stretch, there was some nail biting going on, and you're right. I think not only the fans, but those folks inside that locker room, they expected a comfortable victory.
Yeah, they certainly did, and that just tells you about the NFL. Any given game, you never know how it's going to turn out. You'd better be ready to play.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The 49ers get the win here at home as we say so long from Santa Clara.